our show went.
Kids!
Welcome to Kids Like You. Here we are still nestled in the beautiful Black Hills, and we're coming to you from Mount Rushmore. Hey, I bet you guys can't tell me why they call them the Black Hills.
Oh, excuse me, I was nestling.
You were nestling?
Yeah, you said we were nestled in.
Well, let's nestle into the show here, Joe. A little trivia question for Kids Like You today. Why do you think they call them the Black Hills?
I know.
You do?
Yeah.
Why?
Because they look black when you look at them.
Hey, that's
how do you know why they look black?
Why do they look black, Joe?
Because they got ponderosa pines on them.
How did you remember that? I can't hardly ever get him to remember his lines for
you
kids
know why?
Like you, but he remembered ponderosa pines.
Because I was walking under one and a ponderosa pine cone bonked me on the head.
Well, it was just too big of a head to miss.
I know, it was a big target and it conked me.
Well, the beautiful Black Hills, when you are driving away from them, when you look out in the distance, they look black because they're covered with ponderosa pines.
Yeah.
I've learned something today already.
Yes, they are indigenous to this region.
They are indigenous to this region.
He don't know words like that. I heard the park ranger, Ranger Dell, telling him indigenous.
Well, that's okay.
And then he ran for a dictionary and got it, looked it up.
That's okay. If he learned it from the park ranger, that's what the park rangers are out here. And that's fine. No problem.
He had to repeat to sixth grade. He doesn't know words like that.
Just drop it. We're happy to be in the Black Hills, and we really thank the National Park Service for allowing kids like you to come to you from some of these beautiful spots. Now, in the shows, we've been answering some questions lately. We answered a question, who is God? Who is our Father? Then we answered another one about your stripes, remember?
Yeah.
Who is?
Jesus.
Jesus. Who is Jesus? Well, here's today's question.
I want to know who's been stealing my candy bars.
I know who it is. I heard Yogi Bear and he said, hey,
you
boo-boo. It was boo-boo and Yogi.
It was not
we
a thing.
We are not
you
in Yellowstone Park.
That's what I want to know.
No. Anyway, the question is not who stole Billy's candy bar. The question is,
who is...
the Holy Spirit. Who is the Holy Spirit? If you know who God the Father is and you know who Jesus is, do you know who is the Holy Spirit?
He's the little dove.
No, the Holy Spirit is not a little dove. The Holy Spirit is the person that Jesus said to his disciples that day, I'm going to go on up back to heaven, but it's better for you that I leave, because if I go, then I can send you the Holy Spirit, and he'll live in you, remain in you, be a comforter to you. Have you ever needed to be comforted?
Yeah.
That's what the Holy Spirit's for. Have you ever needed to be taught something? The Holy Spirit will teach you.
God needs
things.
To be taught lots of things.
Yes.
You're teaching me stuff all the time.
Holy Spirit's really using me to teach you a few things. You needed the help, though, and that's what the Holy Spirit's for, to be our teacher, our comforter, to be with us and in us, and who knows where he wants to live. His favorite place to live.
Oh, he wants to live in our hearts.
He wants to live in us. That's exactly right, inside of us. And when the Holy Spirit's in you, he'll guide you and strengthen you and do lots of good things for you. So today on Kids Like You, you're going to be learning a whole lot more about that. Don't miss a minute of it. In fact, let's go right now to the puppets.
I really enjoy watching these guys on TV, huh?
Boy, I know. Some of these preacher shows are so cool. I mean, they just like barely touch the people and they fall over.
Yeah, and I saw one on TV that this lady's leg grew out right then and there.
Yeah,
he prayed for her?
Sometimes the people cry because the Lord is really touching them. It's so neat to watch.
Yeah, and they're always giving those testimonies after they've been healed or you know, if a problem's been solved in their lives. I think that is so neat.
Looky there. There's people jumping and dancing around and praising the Lord.
Yeah. Boy, I tell you, I can't wait to find out what's happening. You know, they always have those testimonies at the end.
You know, Betty Lou, even not just on TV, but like those big tent preachers worth thousands. thousands of people will be in the tent. They always have this really neat Holy Spirit stuff happening there.
Yeah, I know. You know, I know God the Father. I know God is my Father, and Jesus is my Lord and Savior, and He loves us so much. You know, He died on the cross for us. He loved us so much, but you know, I don't know much about what they're talking about on these shows about the Holy Spirit and all. You know, they're talking about the Holy Spirit moving. I'm not sure I understand all that.
I know what you mean. It's easy to pray to God and talk to Him, and it's easy to know how much Jesus loves us and stuff, but I don't really know who the Holy Spirit is either.
I know it. Me neither.
And I've sure never had Him do anything like that in my life.
Me neither. I don't know that I ever knew that He moved in my life, or you know, I've prayed for people, but I don't recall anything like this happening.
Yeah. It sure would be neat to kind of know who the Holy Spirit was.
Yeah, it sure would.
Got some more popcorn over there?
Yeah, I sure do. I can make us some more, too, when that runs out.
Boys and girls, welcome to Red Shirt Table, South Dakota. Your old friend, Chief Joe, wanna be here. Behind me is a mighty great gap, many, many miles between me and the next plateau. So far that a natural human man could not get there without help. And you know what? When Adam and Eve sinned, that was the kind of gap that separated God from man. Yes, man was separated from God, and he was way far away. But you know what? Jesus came to bring us back close to God. And so if you ask Jesus in your heart, there won't be a gap like the one behind me between you and God. So be sure and ask Jesus in your heart today.
Peter Two Feathers was a young Native American boy who was a member of the Lakota Sioux tribe. Otter Two Feathers had a dream in his heart to be a great hunter and warrior. His father and his grandfather taught him many things, but the most important thing to his father and his grandfather was that Otter become a man of prayer. And so early in the morning, his father would wake him up early and take his brothers and sisters out upon the hill to pray. And he would offer up prayers up to the Great Spirit, the Creator. And this is what Otter's father would pray. He would pray, "Oh, Great Spirit, Great Creator, thank you for the earth. Thank you for the hills. Thank you for the water and the buffalo. Thank you for the food and the skin that you provide for us through the animals that you have created. Great Spirit, I ask you to protect us from Ektumi, the great enemy of my people, the spider who weaves his web and comes against my people." And so it was that he would pray that every morning. And as time went on and Otter became taller and he grew up, he decided he did not want to pray anymore. And as his father would offer up prayer, in the middle of the prayer, he would leave and he would go and he would say, "I do not need to pray. I am growing up to be a man. I must learn to be a warrior and a hunter." So as his father was offering up prayers, he would go out into the prairie and he would try to learn the ways of the hunter and the warrior. One day his father found Otter out in the prairie hunting and training. And he came to him and he said, "Otter, why have you not been praying with us in the mornings? Why do I look up and not be able to find you after we have prayed?" And Otter looked at his father and he said, "Father, I do not need to pray. I am becoming a man. I need to learn to hunt and to be a great warrior. You pray, Father, and I will go and learn the way of the warrior and the hunter." His father looked at him as only a father can, and he said, "Otter, if you are ever going to learn to be a great warrior and hunter, you have many other things to learn that are greater than what you can learn in this prairie. So, Otter, because you have not learned how to pray with your family, then I'm going to send you to your grandfather. And your grandfather can teach you to be a great warrior and to be a great hunter." Otter was so happy. He said, "Oh, my grandfather, I've heard many stories of how he can hunt and how he was a man of war." And he was happy to go to his grandfather's teepee. When Otter entered into the teepee of his grandfather, he said, "Oh, grandfather, I am here. Grandfather, I want to show you how that I have been learning to be a hunter and a warrior. What shall I show you that I can do, grandfather? Shall we go out and shall I show you how far that I can throw my spear? Or shall I show you how straight I can shoot my arrow?" And his grandfather looked at him and said, "Otter, you need to be with your grandfather to learn to be a great warrior and a great hunter. But no, Otter, not today. Today I have a lesson for you to learn. And before that lesson comes, I want you to go out because I see that the sun is going down and the moon will soon be hanging into the air and it will be night. Otter, go down and get me fire and get me water so that I may cook." And Otter thought to himself, I don't see how that can teach me to be a warrior. But because he is my grandfather and because I love him above all my relations and respect him as a warrior, I will do as my grandfather said. So he went out and he gathered wood for the fire and water for the food, and he brought it to his grandfather, and they built a big fire and they ate a wonderful meal together. Oh, and after they had eaten, Otter looked at his grandfather and he said, "Grandfather, oh, grandfather, I so desire to learn to be a great warrior and to be a great hunter. Grandfather, tell me the stories of how you fought in your wars, how you became the great hunter and the warrior that you are. Tell me those stories, grandfather, so I may learn." And his grandfather said, "Otter, I shall not tell you those stories today. We need to do the very best lesson, and that is, we must make a prayer." "Oh, grandfather, I don't want to make a prayer." "Otter, this is your first lesson." So as his grandfather prayed to the Great Spirit for guidance and for direction and for protection from Uktumi, then he sat and listened and learned from his grandfather that night, only thinking that the next morning they would get up early to go and learn to hunt and to war. And certainly that morning, before the sun ever came out, his grandfather was waking up Otter. "Otter, it's time to wake up." Otter said, "Oh, grandfather, are we going to go out and hunt? Are we going to go out and learn to war?" And his grandfather said, "No, Otter, we are going to the hill of prayer to offer up prayer to the great Creator." And Otter said, "Grandfather, I am sleepy. I do not want to go." And his grandfather said, "Otter, your bones are lazy and your spirit is lazy. You must learn from me, Otter. Rise up from off of your bed and let's go and pray." He obeyed his grandfather, and there he went upon the hill. And as they stood there to pray, his grandfather turned to Otter and said, "Otter, it is time for you to pray. You offer up prayers to the great spirit creator." And Otter said, "Oh, but grandfather, I do not know how to pray. I have never offered up a prayer." And his grandfather looked at him sternly and said, "Otter, you pray. Because, Otter, if you will ever be a great warrior and a great hunter, you must be a man who is a man of great prayer." Otter thought for a moment, and he said, "Grandfather, I do not need to pray." His grandfather said, "Otter, if you do not pray, then Iktumu will come, and he will weave a web before you, and it will be a web of darkness, and you will get a dark heart, Otter. If you do not give your heart to the Creator, who keeps your heart pure, then you will take that hunting and warring that you learn, and you will do it not for the Creator, but for Iktumu." So Otter looked up into the heavens, and he looked up to the great Creator, and he said, "Oh, great Creator, I ask forgiveness because I have not come to you, because I have not offered up prayers. I pray to you, great Spirit, and I ask you to protect me from Iktumu, the great spider and enemy of the Lakota people. And I pray to you, Great Spirit, for blessings upon me and upon my family. And teach me to be a great warrior for the people. I do not want to have a black heart, but I want to have a white heart, that I can be a warrior not for me, but for my people and for others." And as he finished that prayer, oh, Otter felt so different inside. He felt clean inside. He felt as if he truly had learned the lesson of the warrior. Well, as the story goes, it is told that day after day, people have seen Otter up on the hills praying. He prays not once a day, but several times a day. And as Otter grew to be a great man, he became a great warrior and a great hunter. And because he gave his gift of hunting and warring to the Creator, and because the Creator gave him a clean, white heart, then his name was changed from Otter Two Feathers to Otter, the man of prayer. omid acquiescen.
Gee, Betty Lou, I'm sure glad you could spend the night tonight.
Me too. This is lots of fun, Daisy. I really have fun when you fix my hair and all. I wish you could do something different with it.
Well, I don't know how I can make it look, but we'll try.
Oh, well, anything's an improvement.
So...
Oh, I just remembered something.
Yeah?
You know, the other day I was watching TV, and I saw this preacher on TV, and I was watching how the Holy Spirit was moving in his service. I mean, people were just giving testimonies left and right about all the things the Holy Spirit had been doing. And, you know, I got to thinking, I don't really know the Holy Spirit like those people were talking about.
I know what you mean. Sometimes it seems like some of those guys on TV have such neat stuff happen.
Yeah, you know, I don't know that I've ever experienced anything like that. I don't even know if I'd know the Holy Spirit if he talked to me or moved or anything. How about you, Daisy?
Yeah, I know what you mean, Betty Lou. Hey.
What?
But wait a minute, though.
What?
We have the Holy Spirit moving our lives.
We do, Wynn.
Well, just think a minute, Betty Lou. Remember when you lost your puppy?
Yeah.
And you were so upset because he'd gotten hit by a car and you just got him. And I remember that you prayed and the Holy Spirit just supernaturally comforted you.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. He sure did.
And even though you really were grieved, you felt better because the Holy Spirit was your comforter. And then there was that time, that one time that Bad Butch finally let his guard down and the Holy Spirit gave you power to witness. And you were bold and the Holy Spirit helped you to know what to say to Butch and you were able to minister to him when his dad was having all those problems.
Oh, yeah, I remember that. Yeah, and you know, Butch felt so much better, and he was encouraged, and you know, that was a real miracle for Butch.
Yeah, and you know, Betty Lou, really, it's the Holy Spirit right now helping us to remember all the things that he's done for us.
Yeah, and it's the Holy Spirit that's using you to encourage me about these things too, Daisy.
Yeah, it really is. The Holy Spirit really does move in our life, Betty Lou. He's our teacher, our comforter, our strengthener, gives us power to witness. We really do know who the Holy Spirit is because we hear his voice every day.
Yeah, and you know, I'm going to know his voice better from now on so I'll be able to witness and to share and you know, to be a blessing to other people.
Yeah. Boy, now that we've reminded ourselves who the Holy Spirit is, I bet we're going to hear his voice better all the time and really learn to walk with him just like we walk with Jesus and God our Father.
Yeah!
Oh, man. Well, let's take the curlers out now and see how we look.
Okay, I hope I'm ready for this.
Okay. Guess what time it is?
I don't know. It's real windy and my watch blew away.
You're talking to me at once. I tried to tell you guys not to interrupt when each other was talking. You think it's what?
I said it's windy and it blew my watch away.
It is pretty windy up here on Mount Rushmore. And you think it's supper time?
Yeah.
No, it's not supper time and it's not windy time.
It's howdy doody time.
No.
It's howdy doody time.
Oh, where did these guys come from? It's not. It's the time we have to say goodbye on Kids Like You.
Bye.
We're out of time. That's what I was trying to tell you. We've run out of time on today's edition of Kids Like You, but we sure have enjoyed the beautiful sights that the National Park Service has enabled us to see from Mount Rushmore and from the beautiful Black Hills. Remember our Indian word we learned for Black Hills?
K-Pasa.
Saskatchewan.
Not Saskatchewan, and it's not K-Pasa. That means something else. K-Sapa.
Oh, yeah.
K-Sapa.
The Black Hills. Now, did you two learn anything today? Who is the Holy Spirit?
Yeah. I learned who stole my candy bars.
You did?
Yeah.
How did you learn that?
I think the Holy Spirit told me.
Who did the Holy Spirit tell you did?
It's Joe.
Did you steal his candy bar? You had your own candy bar. What'd you steal his for? You need to repent.
I want it too.
Well, you need to ask God to forgive you, and you need to ask him to forgive you. You don't steal people's candy bars or anything else.
Can I wait and do it after the show? I don't want to be embarrassed in front of all the kids.
Well, I want you to be sure and tell them I'm going to apologize, so they'll know. Tell them you're going to apologize.
I'm going to apologize, but not
he
right
will.
Now.
I'm going to make sure he does. Well, did you learn anything today? Who is the Holy Spirit? Were y'all listening?
I'm still working on that one.
The Holy Spirit is our comforter. The Holy Spirit is our teacher, our strengthener, our friend, our advocate that goes on our behalf before God.
He's glaring at me.
He's quit glaring at him. Boy, they need the Holy Spirit, and so do I, believe me. Working with Joe and Billy, it's a daily overcoming opportunity for Miss Kathy, boys and girls. Anyway, get in here and let's pray for the boys and girls. You may need the Holy Spirit, and obviously I do, and if I do, you all do. So let's pray together right now and ask Jesus in your heart, and the Holy Spirit will come and live in you and ask him to fill you to overflowing. Let's pray with the boys and girls right now. All you have to do is pray a simple prayer like this. Say, Father God.
Father God.
I believe. That Jesus Christ.
That Jesus Christ.
Is the Son of God.
Is the Son of God.
Who died on the cross.
Who died on the cross.
For all of my sins.
For all my sins.
God raised him from the dead.
God raised him from the dead.
And made him Lord.
And made him Lord.
I make him my Lord.
I make him my Lord.
Right now.
Right now.
Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
I'm a child of God.
I'm a child of God.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus lives in your heart. You can count on the Holy Spirit being your comforter, your strengthener, your guide, your intercessor. Let him pray through you, and he'll teach you a whole lot of wonderful things that you need to know. We're glad you prayed that prayer. Be sure and write us a letter, and be sure and pray for Joe and Billy. They need lots of prayer, and we have some business to take care of after the program today, don't we? We'll see you next time, because we really love
kids like you.
Bye-bye.
Joining us today for this exciting edition of Kids Like You. Tune in again, same time, same channel. If you're enjoying the program, then drop us a line at Kids Like You, P.O. Box 22007, Little Rock, Arkansas 72221. Okay, you're going to do it now, aren't you? That's P.O. Box 22007, Little Rock, Arkansas 72221. We're going to be looking for your letter, so do it today. Miss Kathy, me, and the whole crew will be looking for you next time on Kids Like You.